Hello and welcome to Unity Gurus. In this video, we will learn how to make texture maps for PBR material. There are lots of paid and free software in which you can make these PBR textures, such as Substance Painter, Quixel Suite, 3D Code, Photoshop, and so on. But the software which I'm gonna use, as you have already know it by the title of this video, is Materialize from Bounding Box Software. I personally like this software not only because it's free and open source, but because it's made in Unity. Using Materialize, you can make photorealistic material from any image. It generates 6 different types of texture map from a single image. It also provides a real-time preview of your final material. And you can also generate seamless textures quite easily. So without wasting time, let's get started. To download the Materialize, go to boundingboxsoftware.com/materialize and download the zip file from this link and extract to your working folder. Start the Materialize by double click on it. As you can see, it has very simple UI and most of the options are self-explanatory. I will explain each option throughout this video. For the demo, I have already downloaded this metal weave texture from 3dtexture.me. Let's generate all the required PBR map from this diffuse map. In all these slots, you can see P, C, O and S button. Let me quickly explain these buttons. O for open and S for saving the map. C for copy and P for paste, which means you can copy modified texture into one another slot. In some cases, this option is very useful. I import my diffuse map by clicking the O button in the diffuse map slot. Go to your folder and select the texture and you can instantly see a preview of your diffuse map. You can rotate this object by right click, move it by middle mouse button and zoom in zoom out by mouse scroll wheel. Very simple. Next, you click on this show full material to get the final result of your material. In this window, you can change various parameters of your material such as metallic, smoothness, AO, etc. You can also change the light's color and intensity, but I like to keep it default. Keep in mind that in this tool, undo doesn't work, so change any value very carefully. And finally, you can see your material preview on different kind of objects like plane, cube, cylinder, and sphere. Alright, right now you can see that your material is looking very flat. That is because we haven't made these additional texture maps, which are required to get the photorealistic result. So let's start by making height map first. You can generate an automatic height map by just clicking on this create button in the height map slot. But before clicking on this create button, I want to show you that the create button on normal, age and AO map is grayed out. Why? Because these maps are generated from the height map data. So you must need to make your height map very precisely, otherwise you won't get proper detail in your normal and AO maps. These metallic and smoothness map have nothing to do with height map data because these are directly generated from diffuse map. You can see a complete list on Bounding Box website to know which map is generated from which map. Next, I click on this create button to generate height map and you can quickly see both your diffuse and height map on the preview object. You can use this slider to increase or decrease the preview range of your map and below are some options to control the output of your map. You can also use these predefined presets, which are very useful to quickly see a basic preview of your final material. Simply click on this Set as Height Map button and click on Show Full Material to instantly see the final result. You can again edit the map by clicking on this Create button. You can also save and load your project if you want to edit it later. Now the question is, how do we make our height map? I mean, which setting should we use to get a proper height map? Well, one option is that you can adjust these parameters. Set the map and go back and forth to see final material until you get a desired result. But as you know, it's not a great approach to make these maps. That's why I have some tips to save your time and get the most accurate result. Before set these parameters, let's first understand what a height map is. Basically, height map is similar to bump map in old diffuse specular setup, which is used to show ups and down on a surface. To make it more clear, I have prepared a very simple height map. In this map, the background color is mid-gray, RGB 128. At the top, it has 3 squares, black RGB 0, mid-gray RGB 128, which is fully blended in the background, pure white RGB 255. It also has some gradient which are black to white, gray to black and gray to white. And same for these circles. Let's try this texture in Materialize and see how it looks like. Okay, in this another empty project, first import the texture in diffuse slot. Then click on this C button to copy this texture and paste it in the height map slot by pressing this P button and see the final material. As you can see that this gray rectangle and the background is unchanged. This black is completely down and white is completely up. And these gradients have a smooth transition from top to bottom according to their values. So you only use flat color if your texture has sharp bumps. But if your texture has smooth bumps in it, then you must need to use a gradient instead of a flat color. Clear? I hope now you're ready to make your the height map. As you can see in this final result, this weave shape is extruded in a curved shape. So to make this curved bump, we need a smooth gradient from black to white. Also notice that these small speckles are inside this surface. These are not bumps, so we will hide them in our height map. First, I choose this displace and default preset, and then simply increase the final contrast to get a nice black to white gradient without any speckles. Feel free to adjust this parameter until you get a desired result. Once you are satisfied with the results, just click on this set as height map button and click on show full material. Voila! Now our material has some displacement in it. Next, go to normal map slot and click create, and it will automatically make a normal map based on our height map data, which is looking very nice. We need to remove this noise to remove small bumps in our material. You can adjust these parameters to reduce the noise in our normal map and decrease this frequency to get a sharp gradient. I think that's enough for the normal map. Simply set the normal map and see the final result. Everything is looking good so far. Next, let's make a metallic map to get a metallic look in our material. So what is mean by metallic map in PBR? In simple words, how much reflection a surface is getting from the environment. So if a surface is more metallic, then it will use more colors from environment and less color from itself. To understand this better, please use this metallic chart from Unity. In this material, as we know, everything is metallic except this darker areas which has less reflectivity due to dirt or something. These speckles are more metallic than other areas, which will make nice variation in reflections. In this map, white means completely metallic and black means zero metallic. So I increase this low and decrease this high parameter until I get nice variation in the speckles. Also increase this luminosity to increase the brightness of overall map. Once you are satisfied with the results, set the metallic map and see the full material. As you can see, now it's looking much more yellow because now it's also receiving yellow color from the environment. You can change the environment by clicking on this next cube map button, and you will notice that it's changing color according to the environment. Now you must be thinking that even though we have made it completely metallic, but still we are not seeing any environment reflection on it. That's because we haven't made the smoothness map. For that, we make smoothness map again by clicking on this create button. Now the question is how the smoothness map works. In simple words, smoothness means how clear are the reflection. Full smoothness means clear reflection like chrome, and less smoothness means blurry reflection like silver. Again, you can check this Unity metallic chart to see how the smoothness map affect both metal and non-metal objects. In this map, white color represents full smoothness or clear reflection, and black means no smoothness or completely blurry reflections. In this scenario, we need a combination of both. We want blurry reflection on these speckles compared to the other parts of this object. That's why I'm trying to make them darker to blur the reflection. There is not any fixed setting for these parameters. You can just keep changing this parameter to get the result you want. Once you are done with the smoothness, see your final material. Now we have both blurry and sharp reflections. You can change this map anytime if you are not satisfied with the results. Next is edge map. This is used to create sharpness in our material, but we don't use this in Unity, so I am skipping this one. Next, move to our final map, which is ambient occlusion map. It is used to achieve depth in our textures. I have made a separate video on how to bake this map from a 3D object and use it in Unity's standard shader. In this case, I think our height map can also be used as an AO map, so I just copy this height map by clicking on the C button and paste it in AO map slot by pressing the P button. Let me tell you that you can copy and paste map like this, but you cannot edit it later by clicking on this create button. As you can see, if I try to click on this create button to edit this map, it shows me an auto-generated map instead of the map which I just pasted. So if you want to edit it later, then you must need to create a new map first. For now, I am happy with my pasted map, so I am not tweaking these parameters. Just click on this full material and you can see how AO map is affecting our material. So that's how you can make all the PBR maps. To save all the maps, just choose the file format you want and simply click on this save project. Choose the file name and click on this select button. This will save your current project with all the settings, which you can edit later, and it will also save all of your texture maps. Alright, that's enough with Materialize. Let's use this texture and make PBR material inside Unity. Before importing these textures, first we need to make a mask map which we will use in the lit material. If you don't know about mask map, please watch my last video on PBR workflow in which I have explained this mask map in detail. I am using Photoshop to make mask map. Open the metallic map and in the green channel paste the AO map. Keep the blue channel black as we don't use it, and paste the smoothness map in the alpha channel and save the final file as a 32-bit TIFF format. Next, copy the diffuse, height, mask, and normal map into the Unity's asset folder and start making our PBR material. I have already set up a demo scene with HDRP pipeline. I'm using this HDRI as an environment, and on my camera I have enabled anti-aliasing and this bloom effect. If you want to know more about this HDRI setup, then please watch my HDRP introduction video. I will add a link in the description. Next, I make a material by right click, create material. In the materials property, assign the diffuse in the base color, mask map and normal map. Make sure the normal map is set as normal map texture in the import setting, and also set the height map to single channel. Next, to add height map, first select the displacement mode to pixel displacement, and now select your height map in the height map slot. Next, set the metallic to 1 and adjust some parameter to get the similar result in Unity. One difference you will notice that the height map in Unity is not looking similar to materialize. The reason behind is that in materialize this object is rendered using actual displacement, while in Unity we are using pixel displacement, which is kind of fake displacement without any tessellation, which is also very fast in terms of performance. So there we go, our PBR material is now ready to use. And the cool thing about this is that this will look same in every light condition. I encourage you to make different types of PBR material using this workflow. If you have any queries, you can ask me in the comment section. I'm still working on this lit material in HDRP and surely make more videos on new features like subsurface scattering, iridescence and so on. And finally, if you like my videos, you can now support me on Patreon and also subscribe the channel. I'm getting so many tutorial requests on different topics, which I will surely cover in the future videos. Till then, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll see you in the next video with another HDRP tutorial. Bye-bye.